Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today, we are going to study about a game between two grandmasters of different styles. Grandmaster Mikhail Tal is famous for being an attacking and tactical player, while my favorite player, which I learned most of his games, is Grandmaster Vasily Smyslov. He is famous for being a strategical player, having a sound opening repertoire and positional play. But first, we study an endgame problem at diagram A. As we can see, the last move of white is h4. Now, after this move, black resigned. So this would be your assignment. Analyze this problem, why black resigned. Now we continue to diagram B. This is still in the opening stage. So the moves were knight takes knight, bishop takes knight, bishop takes bishop, dc3, then queen takes queen, rook takes queen. I'm just wondering why black exchanged his queen, since in my opinion white has better development here and more active pieces. So let's continue and analyze this position in the main game. So let's switch to the big chessboard. We start by playing c4. We are all excited about the new trends in chess, such as new variations in the openings are being played in the Tata Steel chess event. Now we go back 50 years ago about this game between Grandmaster Vasily Smyslov versus Mikhail Tal. I want to show you how these two grandmasters have different styles, where Grandmaster Tal cannot respond to the positional style of Grandmaster Smyslov. Continuously, knight f6, g3, c5, bishop g2, this is the English variation or English opening with Franchetto variations. Continuously, knight c6, knight c3, g6, knight f3, bishop g7, castling, b3. This move is somehow a bit new to me, as I discovered now, because this game is 50 years ago. But the idea of this move is inviting piece exchange. And I know there is a motive of this exchange, as it will be shown later. Continuously, d5, cxd5, knxd5, bishop b2, knxc3. This is the diagram B. I don't know why Grandmaster Tal wants to exchange pieces. Bishop takes, pawn takes, queen takes, queen. But there are other moves, is queen a5 looks okay to me. If I'm playing black here, I won't exchange queens here, because I have already exchanged the bishop at g7, a weak kingside. And there's another move also, which is queen c7. Which is still okay, or even a good move. Now let's continue after queen takes queen. Rook takes, bishop f5. Well, black wants to develop, but after this move, knight h4. For me, this is the start where white is already gaining momentum to gain advantage. After this move, bishop e6, then bishop takes, b takes, black now has a double pawn. There's a saying that if you have a double pawn, it's a mortal sin in any position in endgame. So continuously, knight f3, that double pawn would be penetrated by the knight. So f6, avoiding knight jump, knight d2, rook ft8. For example, if f5, then knight f3, c4, knight d4, attacking the bishop, then king f7. This position is much better for white. So continuously, after rook fd8, knight e4, attacking the pawn, c4, knight c5, attacking the bishop, bishop f5, f3, restricting bishop moves, bishop c2, rook takes, king f2, king f7. Now, there's another move here. Rook d1, exchanging pieces. So, after rook takes, bishop takes, b4, white is much better here, as you can see. So, it's still an interesting position, but really, white is better here. So, after this move, king f7, then b4, bishop f5, king a1, e5, knight b7, attacking the rook, rook d7, knight a5, attacking c6 and c4 pawns, c5, b takes c5, one pawn up now for white, rook d5, attacking the pawn, knight b7, protecting it, rook d7, attacking the knight, knight d6 check, king e7, g4, attacking the knight, bishop e6, rook b1, rook c7, rook b7, attacking the rook, rook takes. Exchanging of rooks is advantageous to white. Knight takes, king d7, knight d6, h6, king f2. Now we are in the endgame position, which knight versus bishop, king c6, king e3, a5. If king takes c5 after this move, then there is knight e4 check, so it's not good idea to take the pawn at c5. So after a5, then knight e8, attacking the f6, f5 push, knight g7, attacking the bishop, bishop d7, gf5, gf5, f4. I believe this move is a winning move because the pawn at e5 cannot take the pawn at f4 because the king would be closer to the f5 pawn and having a better position, which can be a reason to win, which is a very good move. After king d5, c6, bishop c8. There are other moves such as bishop takes, but there is knight takes pawn, and if it's king takes pawn, fx e5, which is winning. Now after bishop c8, c7, king d6, approaching the pawn, now h4, black resigns. This is the diagram A. So I leave this position as your assignment. I hope you enjoy watching my YouTube channel and this game. So thank you so much. God bless. Bye.